Hello everyone and welcome back to Limpopo Conservation Park, and today we are going to add the warthogs to the zoo. Yes, very very exciting. Yeah, what are we gonna do? Well, we are starting off with this beautiful wall that I stole from the aardvark habitat, and I did that because first of all I did some research on it, and what you usually see in a warthog habitat is just super simple stuff like a lot of mud, a lot of stones, a lot of rubbish, and that's basically it. And usually you have these like really narrow habitats, and that's what I'm trying to do right over here. I'm creating the nice rock structure on the back, which is going to be a huge planter, but it's also going to be a little shelter space that we have over here for the animals. In game they are not able to use it, don't ask me why, but the hitbox for these animals is, I don't know, 4 times the size of a polar bear, and I don't know, and they don't fit in. I tried to fix it, but in the end I just gave up. For me, it doesn't really matter if the animals are going in, yes or no. If you can use it in the game, yes or no, just has to look good, and that's what it does. So I don't know, please hit fix the hitboxes. Yeah, that would be very very nice. So yeah, as I said, I did some research on the warthog habitats, and what do they need? Well, not a lot, but we are still building some backstage stuff, of course, because I'm really enjoying that. And then we have this like circular narrow habitat which is going around this big planter, and we are starting off with the indoor area actually, which I normally don't do. Normally I build the outdoor and then I'm doing the indoor, but today we are doing it different. Yeah, that's very nice. So I'm building a little viewing area right over there, but we are not going to use it in the end, because I have a big change of plans in the end with the building, but you will see that in the end of the video. I will redo this entire like roof structure, and you will see it comes out very very nice. I just built a little fence, so the fence is quite it's like only 1 meter high, and the staff are able to reach over it. They can feed the animals from there, and that's also going to be the entrance towards the habitat. Yeah, this was supposed to be a little viewing area, and the guests should have been able to go like in between the buildings and see the animals, but as I said, it's gonna be gone in the end of the video. This door, I also used it in the aardvark habitat, and then we are building these little windows that we actually made in the zebra backstage. So I'm using like elements from the zoo, just to make it look nice and look like a cohesive kind of a build. And for this habitat, I really wanted to do like a classical thing, or more like this is the older part of the zoo, and that's what I'm going for, and which is quite difficult to do in this game. As I said in a previous video, we don't have mods, so we are not using the mods, and I really want to use like decals or whatever just to make sure that it looks broken down, and yeah, every piece in Planet Zoo looks so clean and looks so nice. So to build something that is like old and dirty and broken down, it's quite difficult, but I think we got somewhere, and I'm starting to know the pieces that we have to use for this. But first, the indoor part. Yeah, it's not much. There's a lot of like straw beddings, hay, crap, you see some branches, and that's it. It's just a little play area for the animals. They can sleep here, they can, I don't know, whatever warthogs do on in the indoor part. I added some enrichment items, and then I'm using these little branches to decorate the building that we are doing. And you will see me zoom out to the building quite a lot because it doesn't fit. And I don't know. I wasn't really feeling the building. It's quite a simple one, of course. It's only like a few walls and that's it. But it had to pop out a little bit better than it does right now. So I will abandon it and we'll come back to it in the end. But first we add these branches, which is really cool. I like that. So we are keeping these, and maybe we will use it in on some other places as well in the zoo, because it's kind of a nice idea to decorate the walls with this kind of stuff. So what else do we have to talk about? Well, I'm doing a little Q&A video for the 10,000 subscribers. I'm not sure when I'm gonna record it yet. So the post that I did on YouTube might still be out there. So you can basically ask me anything. And you can just leave a comment on the post, or you can join the Discord server. There's a link down in the description. I made an entire channel out there so people can post their questions for the Q&A video, which we are gonna record very, very soon once I get the time for that. Well, as we speak, while I'm recording this, Leader actually has the file for Limpopo, so I won't be able to build in it for probably 2 weeks anyway. So that gives me some time to work on other things like the Q&A video and also on Pine Mountain Sanctuary, which is still going very, very strong. We are pushing out the video, so it's almost my turn to start building again. And I'm really excited about that. I'm also super excited to see what Leader will be doing in Limpopo. It's going to be a nice surprise, hopefully. I'm a big fan of his work, as you might know by now. And he's just an amazing builder, so I can't imagine he's building something that I won't like. So we will see. We will do a tour video around his build, and maybe we can invite him on the tour. We will see. And it will be very, very exciting. You will see that in 2 weeks. So that also means there won't be a new Limpopo episode next week, but hopefully the episode after that will make up for that. Right now we are building a fence, very interesting. It's already finished. That's how fast I built. What I'm trying to do here is create like different viewing areas. I think I also talked about that in the previous episode. I think I don't leave enough space in between habitats and don't give the animals like enough privacy. So I'm really trying to do that in this episode. And you will see me dropping down a lot of foliage in between the fencing, in between like fencing and habitat, so it blocks off like the guest view, and you will only have like a couple of spots which you will have a like perfect view on the habitat itself, but also give the animals some privacy. Right over here in this corner, I will also replace the fencing. I tried to like make this little water thing and change the color, but in the end I wasn't happy with it. This enrichment item just looks so much better, and I wish we could do something with the mod to make this habitat look a bit more realistic. Maybe have some mulch that is recolorable or whatever. I couldn't really find the right pieces for it yet. But I'm basically dropping down a lot of crap here. Some branches, some broken trees. I'm trying to make this habitat look interesting. As I said, warthogs don't really need much in the habitat. And if you look up like reference images on Google, on like exhibits, on enclosures for warthogs, it's all the same thing. It's like grass, sand, and that's it. And nothing much going on. And I'm trying to make it look interesting because, that's what we do on this channel, right? We try to make something that looks nice and that we are happy with in the end, instead of just dropping down a fence, throw the animals in, and there you go, looks nice. On the other hand, I still want to keep it realistic. So I think it comes out really, really well in the end. I wasn't really feeling it in the beginning, then I left it for like a couple of days again, and then I went back into it. I had a lot of inspiration, and I'm super happy with how this turned out in the end. It looks realistic to me. I think it fits. I think like it checks off every like animal need things, that kind of things. I'm super happy with the results. Please let me know down in the comments what you think. I'm always really excited to see all your comments. I always respond to every single comment on my channel, and I'm just super happy when I see you guys commenting on the videos to see if you're enjoying the series, if you're enjoying the build, if you like it, if you don't like it, if you have tips. Always good to receive some tips on you should do this, or this could be better, this is more realistic. I'm always really happy to get that kind of feedback. So we already got in with the foliage, trying to use the same foliage all around the zoo, but I found a new little tree that I'm super happy with, and I want to thank SDM Wolf for that. I saw him using that in Pine Mountain Sanctuary, And I was like, oh, that looks really nice. And it's actually a little palm tree that was used or that was released with the aquatic pack. And I never thought of using it like a little grass piece. But in a few minutes, you will see me using it and you will already see why I love it, because it's a really nice little structure. It's a nice color that fits within this biome. Because that's also a thing, if you try different foliage, somehow the color is like completely different and it doesn't fit within the build. So I'm really experimenting with some foliage, and in the end I want to have like a group of foliage that I can use throughout this project. A little bit of a different fence right over here. It's not much, just a couple of branches, but it looked nice. And this is blocking off the view for the guests to give the animals some bit of a bit of privacy. Right over here. And then we also have this little staff area on the side. We already put some concrete down for that. And then we are blocking off the view for the guests towards the staff area with these branches again. Dropping down the branches just to make sure that the animals can't escape. And it looks nice. It looks, it makes it look a little bit more interesting. And then we are building this wonderful gate, and I actually saw this in a YouTube video where the staff would hit something and then all the war dogs would come running towards them. They wanted food and they were able to feed them through the fence, so through the bottom part. And they actually have these like two different kind of mesh fences, and that's exactly what I did right here. So the staff would be able to feed them through the fence right over here. And then for the other part of the fence, I'm just using these normal mesh fence pieces. And then I'm blocking off the view again with these wonderful cloth things. Again, I saw, I think it was Drew using it in Pine Mountain Sanctuary. So I'm super happy with these kind of projects. When you do a collaboration, you can really learn a lot from each other and get inspired some people or by other people. And learn to use new pieces. I'm always like using the same pieces, and because I know it and I know what I can do with it. But it's always good to experiment again with the pieces. Although I have like 1,000 hours in the game, there is still so much to learn. And if you compare this to builds that I did in Veluwe Zoo, it's so much better. And even with the previous builds that we did in Limpopo, I already see like a little improvement. It looks much more interesting throughout, and I'm trying to put more and more details into these builds. Oh, there you go. That was the tree that I was talking about. See how beautiful it is. It really gives you a nice effect. Look at that. I'm placing it everywhere. So probably that's going to be my new favorite piece, together with this grass piece that was introduced with the new pack. Look at that. How beautiful. See, I'm dropping it down everywhere. So SDN, if you're watching this, thank you very much for this one. And then we are finishing off the little habitat that we did, and we are going back to the building. Yeah, I saw this on Facebook. I think it was Toves that started a building with these Betty platforms. And I was like, oh, that's really nice. It has a really nice texture on it. That's exactly what we want in Limpopo for like the older buildings. I'm always complaining that everything looks like nice and clean. And finally I found a wood piece that doesn't. The only problem is it's a huge thing and there's only one plank, which is like 2,000 meters long, and so you can't really do much with it. So that's kind of a struggle. This is the plank that I'm talking about, and you can see I'm trying to finish off the building, but of course I can't. Then I try to do it like this, and then it doesn't fit, and you don't even want to know what a struggle this was. Probably it took me like an hour to finish off the building. See, I did like that, but it looks stupid. So I'm going back in with some normal Planet Zoo planks, I think. But still, the roof didn't, it didn't look like right. So I'm trying to expand it, copy it again, and it doesn't feel right in the end. So you will see what I will do in just a couple of seconds. And so there you go. I dropped down the roof and I was like, yeah, that looks much better. So basically the wall was just way too high. The building looked stupid. And just by dropping down the roof, I had to redo everything. That was like the downside of it, but it looks much better. So I'm going back in with like the mud pieces. And I'm redoing the entire thing. And then on the side, I actually removed some of the walls and I made like an open area right over there, and it looked so much better. And I, yeah, basically like this decision of dropping down the roof made me really, really happy with the final build. We are doing a bit more detailing on the interior, as you can see, using these planks all over the place, because yeah, just the texture on it looks really, really nice. Then the mod wall pieces, like the gridless piece, they are a bit thinner than the usual wall. See what I was talking about? Over there you have the jetty platforms, and I'm not putting a wall back in because it just looks nice, and I made it by accident. How wonderful is that? So in the end, we will finish it off with like a little backstage area, as we are doing right now. Of course, little light switch. I really love this trick. And yeah, there's not much else going on. I will completely change the pathing, because over here I decided, okay, this is only going to be for the staff. So in the end, I will remove this. Oh, I'm doing it right now. I'm removing this viewing platform, and then changing the pathing all over the place, making sure there's a bit more distance in between the habitat. And yeah, I will basically block off the entire view for the guests. I will make this separate outdoor area where they can separate the animals. And that was already the end of the speed build. So I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do. If you want to support me, make sure you become a member. And I'm gonna speak to you guys in the next video. Goodbye and yoo-yoo.